We are here at the Future of Information and Communication Conference, talking to the authors of some of the most highly valued papers being presented here. In this episode, I'm talking to Lee Allen, who presented his case study on bringing computer science education to secondary teachers in West Tennessee. Yes. Now, Lee, let's start off with the primary basis. Why is it important to bring computer science education to younger and younger kids?
It's been known in the United States that we're lagging behind in other education systems throughout the world, even in countries that, you know, some would say are not even first world, et cetera. But there's a dramatic decrease in, if you look at, in math and science, and especially, again, in engineering and in computing science, there is a noted lack of educational opportunities until they reach higher education in universities and college. So that's one of the primary motives to try to bring that to the younger and younger students.
Exactly. So explain to our viewers a bit, how did this project work? What did you guys set out to do?
Well, initially it was my involvement with STEM, the West Tennessee STEM Collaboratory, started in 2012. This grant came available by the United States Department of Education and the Tennessee Higher Education Commission, which is responsible for the distribution, in 2016. I applied, my proposal was accepted, and went forward with the grant. The grant was to see if exposure to a week, because there was limited funds to a degree, to an exposure to a week-long workshop and you know, essentially professional development opportunities, plus the ability to work with computer modules that were created by teachers, would actually enhance the ability for these teachers to use it in their own classrooms.
Okay, and what were some of the key takeaways that you could present here at the conference?
Well, unfortunately, one of the key takeaways was that, and it's not atypical, is that once they left the classroom, we surveyed them in the fall, and they were not really allowed by their school districts to use the modules and the content we provided them to you for free, that they could use, you know, at will, because of the tight reins of the curriculum by the state.
And, yeah, so and they came back all excited and they said, let's do this in the school.
Yes,
and
absolutely. And the survey responses.
Door slammed.
Yes, it did. So they really liked it. They really learned a lot. But as soon as they got back to the classroom, sorry, you know, here's the books. Here's what you need to do. So.
Okay. And the other takeaway?
The other one was a surprising outcome of a pre and post survey that showed that the attitudes towards, even though we had a predominantly female, these are high school and middle school teachers, predominantly female, 80%, actually still felt that computer science as an education and as a profession was in the male domain, was that primarily males were responsible for doing it, I guess, essentially for being the providers of that type of education and being the professionals out in the field, which was sad because we had a lot of female presenters and instructors.
Why is it important to address that gender diversification?
I think it's important because we have this, I think there's a perceptual, you know, continuation of things that are old-fashioned, I guess, if you will, but something that it's been on a continuum. I mean, even if you think of movies like Hidden Figures, where they showed the NASA scientists were female and black, that they, you know, managed to show that they could do it. And so there's still this perception, oh, no, they can't do it. They're better as secretaries or, you know, they what do they have any business doing computing science? We have to break this stereotype. It's not even prevalent elsewhere as much in the world as it is in the United States to this day.
Yeah, and we need to break that in order to get the workforce
Absolutely.
Of the future ready, right?
Absolutely. We can't just leave boys and girls separated there and say, you will do this, you will do that. That's antiquated.
Interesting. Now, it's interesting, this paper was presented here at FICC,
yes.
which is from machine learning, ambient technology,
yes.
networking, and then you did your presentation yesterday. What were some of the responses you got from the delegates here?
Well, at first I thought I was at the wrong session because the people before me and after me were very, very much technical experts and knew their computing machinery, essentially knew coding and things like that to a T. Mine was simply taken from the perspective of how do we improve education education in the computer sciences. So, but I was very surprised. I had a lot of questions. Several people wanted to meet with me afterwards. So I was very taken aback a bit by the positive response about this interest in educating, you know, younger and younger people about computer science rather than be an expert.
All right. So for those of our viewers who've never been to an FICC conference, how would you describe this experience?
Oh, it's very much a social event. Also, people talk. There's a commonality, a community of practice here, obviously, where people speak the same language, and that's it's fascinating. And of course, it's in a lovely location. We're in San Francisco, so I can't complain about that.
All right, Lee, thank you very much for sharing that, and thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. If you're curious to learn more about the innovations presented here at FICC, check out the SAI conference website. Hit subscribe right now here on YouTube and be the first to know when a new video gets published. And I guess Lee and I hope to see you in person at one of our next conferences.
Thank you.